Hey guys, Jason here from Skeleton Key Tactical. We're up in northern Idaho at the range with Alien Gear Holsters, and we're doing some good range development, pistol shooting development skills here. We want to talk a little bit about shooting one-handed and having to do a magazine change if you run your gun dry with only one hand. As we said before in a different video, you might end up having to shoot one-handed if you're nursing an injury and you get your arm in a sling or a cast, or heaven forbid you end up in a gunfight and get shot on one side and have to work your way out of that with only one hand to shoot your pistol. So let's get started here and see how this goes. If I'm already in the process of shooting and I run my gun dry with one hand, okay, here I am. And I shoot it dry. And I go, okay, oh hell, I gotta get rid of this and get it reloaded. So there's a couple things I can do. I'm getting rid of the mag first, put it in the holster, and then go for my spare mag. Or you can put the gun in the holster, pull the magazine out, pull it out this way, take the new one and put the old one back. Either way is fine. Once I get the new one in my hand, I'm gonna come back in, push it in until it clicks and seats, and I can either come up and hit the slide release button with my hand, with my my thumb, or I can use my belt to rack it, or I can use my holster to rack it, or I can take a knee and use my heel of my boot to rack it. Boots work better than soft sole tennis shoes, obviously, but any one of those will work. You notice that I did a little bit of turn there, because I wouldn't probably do that in the real world in an actual gunfight, but we're on the range here and I'm trying to maintain some safety and keep the gun pointing in the same direction. So that's, you know, hence this and everything else. And then we're loaded, we're right back up and running. Okay, all good to go. Let's talk about this now. Say we're doing this left-handed. I'm gonna grab my empty mag here and do this the other way around, okay, because it's a little bit different. So I'm here. I shoot my pistol dry, slide lock. At this point, if you're good at this with your left hand, you can hit your mag release button, or you can do a couple different things. And this is where we have to editorialize a little bit here, okay? A lot of guys get taught there's a couple ways to do this. You can step forward, you don't have to step forward, you can put your gun back in your holster, okay? Obviously with a holster designed for a tack light, this doesn't go in the opposite way as well as I would like it to, so this may or may not work. I don't know if I can, I don't think that's gonna work on this one, so I'm gonna try a different option. Second option is I can do this and pin it between my knees, pull the magazine out, and then get a new one in. That works just fine like that. I don't particularly care for this technique right here, because once I go like this, and I'm trying to change magazines, if my armed assailant is moving on me, I have a hard time maneuvering. I have to grab my pistol, run somewhere else, and try to do a reload while I'm already doing that. If your other arm is wounded, but still usable, you know, maybe you have enough strength, you could just pin this, grab your next mag, and get it in. That would work fine if it's just a lower extremity wound. Other thing you can do is you can put it behind your knee, okay, either this one or this one. So that's a case where I'm gonna come in, pin it behind my leg like this, grab my magazine, and I go in, and then I'm up, you know, all these different options, and I'm either gonna rack it again like I did a second ago on my belt or my magazine well or whatever. I got it loaded, and I'm back on target, okay? Two or three different options there. You kind of got to practice that a little bit to figure out what's going to work best for you. Be careful if you're going to practice this on the range, because you got people to your right and left. When you start wanting to turn sideways and put your gun in, now you're facing backup range. Probably going to get yelled at for that one, right? That's going to be where I'm going to turn to the right, come back around, hold it behind my knee this way, right? Or whichever way you want to do that. I don't really care. You just got to, you got to kind of work through it, but don't do it when you're on the range with a bunch of people and you start flagging left and right because it's not safe. And you should figure out a different way, a place to do that so you don't have any issues. That's kind of the down and dirty on that. If you need any more info, go to our YouTube channel or go to aliengearholsters.com. Thanks a lot for watching.